सो फ्रेंड जस्ट टेल मी डू यू लाइक स्टोरीज डू यू लाइक लिसनिंग टू स्टोरीज लेट मी टेल यू फ्रेंड्स आई लाइक बोथ आई लाइक नॉट ओनली लिसनिंग टू स्टोरीज बट ऑल्सो नरेटिंग स्टोरीज एंड दैट्स वाई इन दिस टूडे वीडियो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू नरेट अ स्टोरी और रिसाइट यू अ स्टोरी एंड दिस स्टोरी विल ऑल्सो टीच यू समथिंग स्पेशली it's relatable for all of us. We can relate with this story and we can learn so many things from this single story. So the story goes like this. Once there was death of God, he sent his messenger on earth to bring back the soul of a woman who had just passed away. The messenger obeyed and he came to earth. And then he saw the lady who was dead and along with her three kids were there and all of them they were babies newborn babies and one of the baby she was drinking milk from her mother's breast and one was crying and the third one was crying just by sleeping and one can see the tears the dry tears on her face having seen this The messenger became so anxious about this thing. What to do? What not to do? If I will bring back the soul of this lady, then how will all these girls be nurtured? Who will take care of them? Then he decided not to take the soul of the lady. And then he returned. He went to the death god and then he told everything and said, Sorry. For not obeying whatever you said, actually I couldn't get her soul because my heart was aching just because of that scenario. I can't see. I couldn't bear the pain of leaving all three young newborn babies without a mother. Then the death of God, he became angry and he said, What do you mean by this? What do you think? You are wiser than me, a one who does all the things related to life and death, the one who takes care of the whole universe. It means I am wrong. You have committed a sin and now you have to be punished. Now you will be punished. You will be punished. And for this, you have to went on earth to suffer. And when you will laugh three times for your own foolishness, then only you will be able to again enter into this heaven. After listening this punishment, then the messenger, he became happy because deep down he was thinking that he hadn't committed any crime. And that's why he was happy with that. According to the god of death, then he was sent on the earth. And he was totally naked and it was winters so therefore he was shivering and he was lying on the floor means not on the floor on the ground where he was lying near to that place there was one cobbler he was heading towards the market to get new clothes for his sons seeing that messenger He was not aware of that thing, the cobbler, that he is a messenger. Still, when he had a look on that messenger, then he felt pity for that person, for that man. And instead of buying clothes for his children, he bought a blanket and some clothes for that person. And then he handed over those clothes to the messenger or he asked him to wear. Then the messenger told him, Actually, I had nowhere to live. On this earth, there is no one. Then the cobbler, he said, Okay, you can stay with me. I'll help you. But listen to me carefully. If my wife will get angry because of I got clothes instead of buying my children's clothes, then please keep calm down, okay? He will accept you within some days. Then the cobbler took that messenger along with his along with him to his home. And as soon as the lady saw that man, she started yelling. She yelled a lot. Why didn't you get some clothes for the children? Why did you do this thing? Who is this person to you? You shouldn't have done this. And when all these things were happening, at the same time, the messenger was laughing. He was thinking about neither that person, neither the cobbler nor his wife are aware of that thing, that I am a divine soul. And because of the man brought me here in his house, that's why they will be going to become richer in coming days. Then later on, the messenger started living with all of them. And then one day, he started learning. And he kept learning. And he started making shoes, sandals, everything. And he, within couple of months, he became the skilled one. One day, the king came to the cobbler and said, you know, I got this very precious leather and I want a pair of shoes. So you have to pair shoes. You have to make shoes, pair of shoes, not the sandals. Because at that time, it was ritual when someone dies, okay, then he was buried along with sandals, not with shoes. So the cobbler asked this thing to the messenger, you know, you have to make shoes, not sandals. If you won't, then we will be punished by the king in future. But just because of he got the realization, the messenger got some realization, that's why instead of preparing shoes, he made sandals. And then what happened? The same thing as you are thinking right now. The cobbler started scolding the messenger, and then the messenger started laughing. And when this thing was happening, at the same time, the servant of a king came over there and he told, instead of shoes, you have to make sandals because the king passed away last night. When the cobbler listened this, he started apologizing to the messenger. Please forgive me, I was not aware of that thing. And I think you are a divine person. You are a soul. And just after this, the messenger started laughing again, second time, on his own foolishness. You know, he was thinking like that. Nowadays, people, they judge everything just by that particular moment. Means their focus is only on immediate result. They are not focused on the long-last results. And then the cobbler asked the reason, why are you laughing? Then the messenger said, okay, I'll tell you, but not right now, later on, when I will laugh three times on my own, especially on my foolishness. And after this, the messenger started thinking about those three girls whom he left with their dead mother. One day he was working in his shop and three young girls, they came to the shop for sandals, means for their wedding sandals. And having a look on one of them, the messenger, he recognized these are the same girls whom he left. And then he saw there was also one lady who was looking quite rich and from well-known family. And she was wearing lots of jewelries and everything, but she was quite old. Then the messenger was quite interested to know about this fact. So then he went to that lady and he started asking, just tell me about these girls. Are these your girls, your child? Means, are these your children? Then the lady said, no, they are not my biological daughters. You know, one day when I was going back to my parents' house, then I have seen them, all three of them, they were crying with a dead body of their mama. Then I felt pity on them and I decided to have them with me always, because I at that time I had no kids, so they are just like my kids. And now they have grown, so now they are going to get married in a royal family. Then the messenger, he started thinking about all the things and he again laughed. Third time he laughed. When he started laughing, then the cobbler came and he asked, "Now you have to tell me the reason. Why are you laughing?" Then the messenger said, told everything, the whole scenario from the day when all these girls were crying. And then he got this realization that God has always a better plan as compared to us. You know, friends, we are human beings. We are so concerned only about good results. But you know, it doesn't matter how much you try, but you will get results only according to God, what God has planned for you. Sometimes we put efforts. We want to see the results. But just because of God has decided something for you, so we don't get that goal. We can't achieve that goal. It doesn't mean that you are not good at all. You haven't been putting efforts. You are. But the reason is that God wants you to do something better in your life. In my life, problems came and they made me enough able to be here. If I'm here, then just because of problems. In my case, problems, they played a role of blessings in disguise. Blessings in disguise. And the same thing you have to also do. Second thing, being a human, we always tend to see the instant result. If I am doing something, like I am learning this language and I spend 1 week, and if I am not able to see the instant result, then I always curse myself that this thing is not happening. I'm not good enough in this field. I will never be able to fluent this language. No, you have to keep doing. You will definitely see the result, but in long time. Means you have to do karma. Don't focus on the goal. If you are consistently doing anything, then there's no doubt you will be able to see the result. And then thing I want you to do in your life. Instead of worrying about anything, try to be happy what already you have. If you want to get something in your life, then it's okay. You just need to work on it consistently. You have to maintain that consistency. If you want to master this language, then try to practice again, 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 and again. Because if you want to learn anything, and if you do only one time practice, then this thing will not work according to you. But if you will be able to do 100 time practice, then this thing will definitely work according to you. Okay? So, problems are just like, na, problems always triggered us to find the particular way to navigate through this problem. We always consider adversities like, why this adversity has come into my life. But all the adversities, all problems always come in our life to make us enough stronger, to know about the capability that we already have, to become resilient, to get to know about the potential that we already have inside us, to make you enough strong, to make you enough wiser than earlier. If you want to use your each and every knowledge, then you should need to first figure it out, what potential that you already have inside yourself. And in this world, nothing is impossible if you are really dedicated, passionate for doing something. If you are a kind of a resilient person, then it's okay to fail. It's okay to get failure in life. Then it doesn't mean if you get failure, then it doesn't mean that you are not enough. In this world, there are billions of human beings, okay? And each and every human being is blessed by a particular skill. We just need to find it out. Which one do you like? Which one do you passionate about? And then your life will become happier than the earlier. You have to just keep only one thing in your mind. Just keep working. Don't concern about, you should not concern about the results. If you are doing something, suppose if you are cooking food, so already you will, it means you are going to have your dinner. There is no doubt. So something or the other thing will come in your life as a result, according to your result, according to your actions. Sorry. The action you put, according to them, you will see the result. And now I want you to tell me what kind of person you are and how do you see problems in your life. And never ever be overwhelmed whenever you see problems in your life. Getting overwhelmed is okay, but after some time, just try to calm yourself. Just sit quietly and think about those problems and try to find out the particular way to navigate through that. Okay? And we will meet in our next video. Till then.